Now that we've covered the text tool in Clip Studio Paint, let's move on to how to use the Word Balloon tool. Hi everyone, I'm Muse, and today I'm giving a tutorial on how to use the Word Balloon tool in Clip Studio Paint. This tutorial references what I've already covered in my text tool video, so please watch that video before moving on to this one. Also, this tutorial applies to both the Pro and EX versions of the software, so you do not have to worry about any differences. Now, the Word Balloon tool in the default Clip Studio workspace is located in the same area as the text tool. Right underneath text, you will find the different ways to draw word balloons in Clip Studio Paint. First is to decide which word balloon tool you want to use. The first tool, the ellipse balloon, works like a shape tool, where you click and drag to draw the shape. The curved balloon tool acts like a polyline, where the border will curve with each point you put down with a click until the shape is closed. Finally, the balloon pen acts like a default pen, but will automatically fill in to make a balloon. My favorite is the ellipse balloon because of consistency, but you can use any tool that appeals to you. Second is to set the options in the Word Balloon tool to your liking. Underneath each balloon tool, there are several options in the Tool Property menu, similar to the Text menu. Just like with your font color choice, you can change the default way the program will pick the line color and fill color for your word balloon. The line color refers to the outline, and the fill color to the color inside the balloon. Additionally, in the ellipse and square balloon tools, you can change the shape of the tool between rectangle, ellipse, and polygon. Personally, I use the rectangle shape with the roundness of corner option turned on and maxed out for a differently shaped oval than the default ellipse, but that is just my own preference. You can also change the style of the outline underneath brush shape. Try experimenting with the different settings to find what works best for your style and project. Bonus tip! When you draw a balloon underneath text that's not rasterized, Clip Studio Paint will put them together on one layer. Personally, I like to hide the text layer when drawing balloons, which keeps them separate for edits. This leads us to the third step, how to edit the balloon shape with the Operation tool. To edit word balloons, click on the Operation tool on the upper left side of the default workspace. It looks like a cube with an arrow cursor clicking on it. This allows you to resize the balloon like you're using the Transform tool. When you're happy with the shape of your balloon, click outside of the box to dismiss the tool. Now it's time for step 4. Add a balloon tail to show who was speaking. To add a tail to your balloon, select the text tool once again or press T on your keyboard. Below the tools to draw word balloons are the tools to add tails. They are categorized as normal and thought balloon tails. After selecting a type of balloon tail, you will see a drop-down menu in the Tool Property window next to How to Bend. This will determine how your balloon tail is drawn. Straight line is exactly how it sounds. It will make a straight tail between the section you click to start, and then click again to end your balloon tail. Polyline allows you to select multiple straight bends for your tail. Double-click to set the endpoint for your tail when using Polyline. And finally, Spline works similar to Polyline, but it will curve your tail instead of creating a bend. Double-click to set the endpoint of this tail as well. The Thought Balloon Tail tool has the same options, but will create a tail with dots instead of with lines. And that is how you use the text tool in Clip Studio Paint to create word balloons. I hope that this tutorial has been informative and helpful for you for whatever project you're working on. If this video helped you out, please consider leaving a like and checking out other tutorials that I made on the channel. If you have any further questions about the text tool, leave a comment and I will do my best to find an answer. If you have questions about Clip Studio Paint specifically, I strongly recommend looking at their help website, Clip Studio Ask. The English version will be linked in the description below. Thanks for watching, and until next time, bye!